So what things have IHG done that's felt like you've made people feel really cared for over the last period of time, like in terms of kind of what things have you seen and things that you've done?
I think we started, the main thing has been just a real emphasis on support, which sounds really simple and bland, but yeah. So we started with, we kind of, obviously anyone that works in office kind of got the feeling that at some point we were all going to be sent home because the country was just starting to shut down. Yeah. So the week before it was actually announced, the team I'm in got together and produced kind of an online, we called it the Flex Work Summit
right.
at the time. Because, you know, working flexibly.
Got to have a snappy title.
It's now changed, but you know, at the moment it's a Flex Work Summit. But basically we just got together a ton of resources that people could do individually and a couple of like workouts that leaders could do with their teams that were about, so it was like a Flex Work Summit, we called it. So you come on and look at things about working remotely and how to work remotely. So you could do a questionnaire on kind of how ready am I in terms of my home setup, am I an introvert or an extrovert? Do I need people, all the good stuff?
Yeah.
So some self-reflection and kind of prepping for things. For leading remotely, leaders, how are you going to make sure that your teams feel engaged? So we did a whole kind of piece around, you know, have that call with your team about how we're going to work, what we're going to do, what do people need? And right at the start, there was tons of, and I kind of hate the word well-being because it sounds very bland, but there was just tons of support on kind of, how are you mentally going to get through this? How are you physically? Mm. So, you know, here's your video, how to do yoga at your desk or whatever. Yeah. But then we just put out and made sure it went live on the Monday before we got sent, before lockdown happened on the Tuesday, because we knew it was coming. So as soon as people got sent home, there was a ton of resources that went, we know this is really tough. We know this is really different. Some of you may never have worked from home before in your life. You may have kids that are now home from school. You may, like, you've got everything going on. So this is how we want to make sure you feel supported. So I think from the get-go, it's been an acknowledgement, a tacit acknowledgement to people, this is really weird and this is really tough and here's how we can help you. Yeah. And that has just grown and grown and grown. So that kind of online resource is now the Work Life Summit.
Okay.
A little subtle change. But that's where we pushed out all things about D&I. So we've done spotlights on different elements of D&I and everything's kind of come to the forefront. We've updated all the resources. It's been where people have now gone for their how do I return to work resources, which is stuff about your self-reflection about how mentally prepared are you to come back to work, as also logistically. So there's been this constant place to go for people from the day that they got, you know, we got sent home, that they can go and understand that. And get the message, we know this is difficult. There's also been, we've brought in some new employee assistance programs that people can hook into and get extra support there. So it's just been, it's kind of been the message from day one. Yeah. And the comms team have pushed that out. Keith has pushed that out in his comms, and it's been this, it's been really important. We've had podcasts from leaders about what they've learned about through the crisis and what they've done. Right. So it's just this bank of resources that people can, and it's a kind of a social thing, so people can comment and share. We've got people to make videos about what kind of home working means to them. So yeah, I think it's just having that foundation from day one has just made people know there's a place I can go and there's constant support and I can send in ideas and I can help and I can contribute. And it's not just been how do you singularly do this, it's been right, leaders.
Yeah.
How are you going to make sure this is done? And how are you as a leader? So are you struggling with, have you ever led a remote team before? Because if you haven't, you've got some stuff to learn.
Some help.
So that I think has been just huge, just absolutely huge. And now, like I said, when people are returning to work from furlough in corporate, it's the place they're going to get support as well. And we continue to kind of, and actually talk quite, and it's, the reason I don't like the word well-being is because it's become this kind of bland catch-all piece and can kind of put people off. But we've been really honest and kind of did a whole piece around anxiety and like really kind of, again, back to that talk straight, that be honest. Look, you might be really struggling with this. You might have a really difficult situation. You might just have a lot going on, or you might live on your own. Yeah. So it becomes really lonely. And just having resources about that and things, and not kind of going, oh yeah, we know it's going to be a bit difficult, but let's not be too kind of serious about it. Actually go, this can be really tough for people, and people might need some proper support, and there might be a real crisis people are facing, and helped them with that. And I think it's made people realise this isn't just lip service. You know, the leader I work for or the team I work with get that I am properly struggling, or I could properly struggle, and they're there to support me. It's not just a, oh, well, here's an employee, you know, support number that you can call. It's actual proper, you know, deep dives into mental health and deep dives into different things that you might be struggling with, but also using it as a platform for the D&I piece to kind of go, this is, you know, equally as important that we want people who want this to be at the top of the agenda to see that it is top of the agenda and it is important.
But it's amazing what you can do, isn't it, when the pressure's on and how quickly you can turn stuff around. Other organisations, that would have taken 6-12 months, and you're still kind of figuring it out and not getting on with it.
My manager, she literally came in the room and went, right, what is it you're working on? And if you don't work on it for next week, is it going to fall off a cliff? And we all kind of went, I've got this one thing, but that's when she went, I've got this really, really random idea. Why don't we? And we all went, yeah, let's do it. So it was kind of, it was, and for me, having only been there a few weeks, I was like, oh, so through this. because it was really good to see, like, oh, okay, that's the priority. Oh, that's brilliant. That's absolutely brilliant. So yeah, it was one of those things where you were like, why does it take us ages to do stuff a lot? Because if you just go, let's roll our sleeves up and do it. And it's been brilliant because it meant that we weren't chasing our tail. It meant that people weren't at home for a month, and then we finally went, oh, here's a great guide how to work remotely. And he actually, it was there from day one, and we're able to add to it and build on it. So it's been a really, really, really great way for people to feel that they're properly cared for and supported.
That's impressive. So, like, outside of IHG, what do you think that leaders are going to be struggling with over the next few months? Or is that a silly question? or too long a question?
No, it's interesting, isn't it? Because I think the answer to that question is always skewed by your bias of what's important to you, kind of thing. But so from my quite open bias, I think there's a piece around actual, true, authentic, compassionate leadership. Mm-hmm. So, there's studies on it, but I do think it's true that younger people coming into the workplace, and actually even, I think I'm a millennial, no, what am I? I'm a Gen Z, or I don't even know. Anyway, I'm on like the cusp of like, I'm nothing. I mean, between two generations, but it is definitely true that anyone kind of my age and younger, the majority of those people, it is important to them about what that company does and how they walk through the world. And what that leadership's like, and people just won't put up with, you know, control, command, domineering, I'm the boss, I know the best anymore. So I think leaders who have stuck in that old way of, you need to be in the office, you need to be face to face, you need to be working 9 to 5, you need to be doing this, are just going to fall. They just can't cope, deal with that anymore, because it's just not true. If this has shown us anything, it's that people that work in a corporate environment can be at home for 7 months and they still get stuff done.
Like what you were just saying, an even better, faster, more efficient way as well.
Well, I think it's interesting because I think depending on what kind of business you're in, and if you're in a business where you have a mixture of frontline colleagues and corporate colleagues, it's been quite a different experience. I think... There's the whole knock-on effect that's been talked about in terms of, with people not going back to the offices, city centres are struggling because obviously there's no one going into the coffee shops and stuff, which I get. So I think there's a piece around compassion and actually when do you put people before profit and when do you make tough decisions, and that's going to be, and I think people are going to be far more compassionate about people needing flexibility and people needing more from their job than what is currently on offer. So I think it's those things that have been talked about for ages, and I kind of hate the phrase authentic leadership with a capital A and a capital L, but it is about that authenticity of you do bring your full self to work. You do bring everything with you and all your worries and all your baggage and who you are to work. And I think people who've been forced into a position where they can't do that are not going to really be accepting of that anymore. And I think the flexible working thing is just, I think any leader that doesn't set the tone in their company where we trust you to get the job done no matter where you are or what you're doing, isn't going to get the right talent. Because I think there's going to be, you know, there's so many people looking for a role at the moment who are brilliant. You know, there's people out of work that are absolutely fantastic. And so there's going to come a time where the war for them, the talent war for them, is heating up, and what they'll look for is not the usual things that are normally on offer. You know, his salary may become less important if it means that you can be at home for 2 days a week, or you can. So I think it comes down to, they are kind of buzzwords, but they're real. That compassionate leadership, that authentic leadership.
It just feels like this period of time has just sped that whole up, doesn't it? Because it kind of always was there, and it was kind of, we'll get to that tomorrow type thing, but suddenly it's like bang, straight in front of you.
Absolutely.
And having to do it anyway.
I think it'll be interesting what the impact is on different sectors that are still very old fashioned. I think there's different sectors that are quite forward thinking in those things already, and maybe this is just giving the final push to those last few outliers. But you're right, it has just fast forward something that may have taken 5 years. It's every company's been now having to look at, how do we actually treat people and what do we actually ask of people? And I think there was something on one of the many talking heads on the news the other day about the difference between how private companies seem to be far more compassionate than the government are being to their civil servants at the moment. You know, the government are like, civil servants, get back to work, get in the office. And so many private companies, the one I work for including, I know so many massive corporates that are like, it's cool, stay at home. So it's
12 months ago, if you asked what would have happened, you wouldn't have gone that way, probably, would you?
If you know, 12 months ago, if you struck lucky and had a line manager or leader that did really trust you and did believe in it, and maybe themselves worked flexibly, great. But they were, you know, they were the outliers. And I think that's flipped on its head now. And it's going to be really interesting to see what impact that has on what roles people go for and what companies come out of it with. You know, it's been really interesting to see what companies have come out faring really well from this because of how they've led their people through it. And I think it's really changed some people's perception of some companies, because you assume that a massive giant corporate would just be, get yourself back to work, get back to that office, do this. But actually a lot of them are like, that's fine, which is very unexpected, I think.
Yeah, absolutely. Sophie, thank you. It's been really lovely chatting. It's been, I really appreciate the time, so thank you so much.